This is Sunitha from Department of Chemistry, Satibama Institute of Science and Technology. Today I am here to talk about one of the practical session which is useful for the BE BTech students who is pursuing first year, first semester or second semester chemistry laboratory experiments. So we have so many experiments like EDTA, glycine, pH, iron, etc. Among all these things, so I am going to perform estimation of strength of HCl by pH meter. Say pH is nothing but negative logarithm of H plus ion concentration. So pH is equal to minus log base 10 H plus ion concentration. So why we are measuring the pH of a solution? So pH will give you the hydrogen ion concentration present in the solution. So our experiment is nothing but determination of strength of acid present in a solution. So we are not directly measuring the H plus ion, we are measuring the pH of a solution, so which will correlate and which will give you the how much amount of H plus ions present in a solution. So that is what we are going to measure in this experiment. The experiment is called estimation of the strength of HCl solution by pH meter. So what is pH? So pH is nothing but minus log of base 10 H plus ion concentration. Clear? Now, so for measuring this, what are all the apparatus we require means? So we require glass, electrode, pH meter, sodium hydroxide, HCl, burette, beaker, etc. A glass electrode is a one. It is an ion selective electrode which measures the H plus ion concentration present in the solution. So it is made up of a glass, and at the bottom you will have a, I will show you, you will have a glass and inside which it was filled up with the KCl solution having silver electrode. Now by using all these things, so we are going to measure the H plus ion concentration present in the given HCl solution. So what we are going to do, so this is not like simple acid based titration. See, we can estimate the amount of HCl present in a solution by simple acid based titration, but what is the advantages of this pH titration over volumetric titration is, volumetric titration as a human we are doing, we may commit some mistakes that we can rectify, and no need of use any indicator. So it's an instrument, it is going to give the all the values, so it may be like it will be accurate and precise value you will get, because we are going to calculate the endpoint only from the graph which we are going to plot. Here we won't perform like ordinary volumetric titration as titration 1 and titration 2. Here only one titration. So what we are going to do, so we are going to measure the pH of a solution . So this is volume of sodium hydroxide and we will measure pH of the solution. So how we are going to measure? By adding sodium hydroxide from the burette to the HCl ion solution. Where we are going to take? We are going to take in the beaker. So with this we are going to perform the titration and we will measure the endpoint. So we are not going to calculate the amount also, we are going to calculate only the strength. The strength present in the strength of the H plus ion present in the HCl solution by using pH meter. So now I will show you the demonstration. So after showing the demonstration, I will take all the values and I will tabulate all the values. So with that values, I will draw the graph. So once you see the graph, then you can calculate the endpoint. Then at last we will complete with this calculations. Clear? So now let us start the demo class for pH titration by pH meter. First, before you start any experiment in the chemistry laboratory, so you have to first wash all the equipments, whatever you are going to use inside the chemistry laboratory, by tap water and rinse it with distilled water. Keep that in mind. You have to collect, this is called wash bottle, only in this wash bottle you will collect all the distilled water. Now I am going to take the sodium hydroxide. So for this titration you require only two solutions. One is called PHHCl, it will be marked in the laboratory, and the second one is pH sodium hydroxide. So what I am going to do, I am going to take this sodium hydroxide in this burette after washing, and I am going to make up this HCl solution in this 100 ml standard flask. So first what I am going to do is, I will wash all the apparatus whichever I am going to use. First the burette. So burette has to be washed with distilled water. Why you have to wash means, because any solutions, the previous batches or whomsoever it may be, they would have done, then it will contaminate your solution. So you should get the correct value for that purpose only. So you have to wash all the apparatus. So once when you are washing, you have to wash, keep that in mind, you have to wash the nozzle point also. Clear? Then take a little amount of distilled water, shake well, and completely drain through the nozzle point. And what is the solution we are going to take in this burette? So we are going to take the sodium hydroxide, pH sodium hydroxide. So you are all a student, you should know how to fill it up. So what you have to do, first you have to keep the funnel like this. To release the pressure, you have to lift, and first you add a little amount. Then rinse the burette with corresponding solution, not only for this pH titration, whatever the experiment you are going to do it in the chemistry laboratory, so you have to rinse the burette or the pipette with the corresponding solution. Keep that in mind, and I'm draining all the solution only through the nozzle point. Clear? Now keep the burette, carefully transfer the sodium hydroxide solution. Keep that in mind, when you're transferring the sodium hydroxide solution, it should not contain any air bubble inside the burette. Yes, it's almost over. See, once you fill up the solution, don't adjust for zero reading. First, what you have to do? So first, you have to fill the nozzle point. That is the first and foremost thing you should follow in the lab for all the experiments. So drain the solution till my nozzle does not have any air bubble. You must be knowing this is a colorless solution. For all colorless solutions, so we will be watching, we will be considering only the lower meniscus. So what is meant by lower meniscus? The bottom part of the curve should go and touches this zero mark. That is called lower meniscus, because you would have aware of it, and adjust the burette reading for zero marking. So when you're adjusting the burette reading, don't keep the burette like. So you have to keep the burette exactly at your eye level, otherwise it may lead to parallax error. So keep the burette at your eye level and adjust the reading for zero marking. And what is the meniscus I told you? So you should follow the lower meniscus. So once you completed the buretting out the solution, so you have to clamp the burette in this corresponding burette stand. Now my burette solution is ready for titration. Keep it away. What did I tell? Now I'm going to make up the solution. See, we will give the high concentrated solution like this. So what you have to do, you have to make it up. Why you have to make it up? Because I have some normality of sodium hydroxide. With this, it has to match. So for that purpose, you should not pipette out the high concentrated solution. What you have to do, you have to dilute the solution in this 100 ml standard flask. Don't pipette out directly. So what you have to do, first you wash this one. As usual, any apparatus in the lab, whenever you are using, first wash it with tap water and rinse it with a little amount of distilled water. All the washings for each and every experiment, whatever you perform in the lab, you have to follow. Clear? Then take the funnel, wash it off, because I have used the sodium hydroxide. Keep it like this. This is called glass rod. Wash it off. See, hold the glass rod like this. It's all depending upon whether you are left-handed or right-handed. So I am a right-handed, so I will hold the glass rod in the left hand and carefully transfer the given pH solution into this 100 ml standard flask. Don't allow even a single drop to fall outside. Is it clear? Because one drop outside, your mark will also be outside only. Okay, don't take your left hand, take distilled water, add little, then rinse, transfer the solution. So when the solution is not draining, what you have to do? So you have to adjust the funnel to release the pressure. So second time, rinse, transfer, then third time, two times or three times, that is more than sufficient. So any amount of the solution which sticks inside this small bottle will be transferred thoroughly. Is it clear? Now keep this bottle away. See, drain the solution by releasing the pressure. Now wash the glass rod. Now only I have to take my left hand, keep it here, and wash the mouth of the funnel and as well as stem of the funnel. Okay, you see how many washings I have done, and all my washings has come below the neck of the standard flask. So you should not keep the funnel, and you should not keep on water, then it may lead to excess. So now what you have to do, take the pipette, open this wash bottle. Before you use anything, as I told you, you need to wash. Now pipette out this solution, I mean distilled water. Now this is the standard flask. Here only you have the mark. Exactly up to this level you have to add the distilled water. See, you can add directly. Sometimes what will happen means you may add excess. Again, you have to pour the solution, then strength will not be correct. So don't do any exercise inside the lab. Take the pipette, add drop wise like this. Now when you are nearing that marking, what you have to do, you should add drop wise. Clear? Now see, again this is also a colorless solution. What meniscus I am following? Lower meniscus. Close this by using the lid and shake well for uniform concentration. So you have to shake the solution, because down you have the HCl solution, above you have added water, so all should be uniform. For that purpose only what we are doing, you are shaking the solution for uniform concentration. Keep that in mind. The given pH solution in the small bottle, you have to make it up in this 100 ml standard flask. Without making up, if you pipette out, it will not be exactly 20 ml. If you do like this, definitely it will be a mistake. Is it clear? Now shake well, ups and downs at least for 10 times. Clear? Now after shaking, some solution may fall. Don't bother about this. Then again, no need to add. Already we have done it. No need to add it again. Is it clear? So after shaking, whether it will not be up, it will be coming down. No need to worry. Then what you have to do, take the 100 ml beaker. So as I told you, we have to wash. So from this solution, you have to pipette out exactly 20 ml. Before you pipette out 20 ml, you have to rinse the burette by using the corresponding pipette solution. Whether it is a burette or a pipette, you have to rinse the corresponding solution in the pipette. Don't blow. Now you have to pipette out exactly 20 ml. Thank you. Now this is also a colorless solution. What meniscus? Lower meniscus. Carefully transfer the pipette out 20 ml of made up HCl solution in the beaker. Don't blow. If at all possible, just gentle tap. Then you have to pipette out 20 ml of distilled water. You may ask, why madam we should pipette out 20 ml of distilled water? I will tell you why we are adding 20 ml of distilled water. Keep it away. Now my burette solution and pipette solution both are ready. See, now this is called pH meter. It was already calibrated by using the buffer tablets pH 4 and pH 7. No need to touch any dobs. Once when you come the laboratory, see, all are having everything. Suppose it will be always in standby. This knob alone you have to turn to pH. Standby, MV and pH. This is distilled water, approximately it is showing the neutral pH. So as I told you, this is called glass electrode. Now you see now that bulb, as I told you earlier, the bulb is down, which consists of inside silver electrode, and you have the KCl solution. Now if you pipette out only 20 ml of acid, the bulb may not be immersed completely. For that purpose only, what we are doing, we are pipetting out 20 ml of acid plus 20 ml of water. Now you keep this bulb here. This is only water, nothing will happen. No need to wash this. Carefully you have to handle this pH electrode and keep it like this. Is it clear? Now take the glass rod, wash it off and keep it here. Before you start the titration, and you see here, without adding sodium hydroxide, what you have to do, take the glass rod, see the solution, so note down the pH. So it is showing approximately 1.09. Now what you have to do, from the burette, before you start the burette reading, it is mandatory to check whether it is having leaking or not. Now surprisingly, my burette, it is not leaking. Now you can add 0.5 ml. So each and every time when you are adding 0.5 ml, so please remove the burette, add exactly 0.5 and keep at your eye level and check. So only you can avoid the parallax error. So after adding this, keep the burette at your eye level and then add. See, I need to add 0.1 ml. Yes, I have done. Now clamp the burette. Now stir the solution. So I have added 0.5 ml. You see, like, there is an increase in pH value. So like this, what you have to do, after adding each 0.5 ml addition of sodium hydroxide from the burette, you have to measure the pH. So I will show you 10 readings like this. You have to follow till 15 ml. So including 0, how much you will get? So you will get totally 31 readings. Clear? Now I will add 1 ml. But keep that in mind, each time you have to remove the burette and please check whether you are adding correctly or not. So we are experienced, we will add directly. So each time you have to stir the solution. Don't stir by using the electrodes. Glass electrodes are costly. You should not break the bulb also. Now you see, again the pH increases. So I will note down all the readings. The first one 1.25 and the second one is 1.27 and the third one is 1.28. So now again you have to add 1.5. Don't allow even a single drop to fall outside. Now you see, again the pH increases. So the pH will increases gradually till the end point. Once you reach the end point, so what will happen? Again, the pH will increase only gradually, because that pH is only due to the sodium hydroxide. So you know the pH range. The pH for acid will be around 1 to 2 and the pH for the base will be around 10 to 11 or 12. So within this range only the pH meter will work, and you will have the gradual increase in between the points till you reach the end point. So once you reach the end point, so you can come to a conclusion. So it may be between 7 or 8 or 8 or 9 or 9 or 10. It's all depending upon the concentration of the HCl what we are given in the lab. So like this, you have to continue the titration till 15 ml. So including 0, there will be a 31 readings. Note down all the points in the observation given to you. Then you have to do the plotting. Now I will write all the values and the board, and I will show you how to do the graph. See, now we have completed all the values by using the pH meter. Now by using the values, I will show you how to do the calculation. And first you have to draw the tabular column. The tabular column consists of serial number, and here you take volume of sodium hydroxide, and for the corresponding volume you take the pH, and delta pH, then delta V. The last column will be delta pH by delta V. So you have to note down all the values. Now first I will write for the 10 values. Now you plot all, you write all the values in the tabular column. So I have taken, so for 0 it is 1.25, for 0.5 it is 1.27, 1.28, 1.31, for 2, 1.37, for 2.5, 1.40, for 3, 1.44, for 3.5, 1.44, for 4, 1.59, for 4.5, 1.72, delta V. So I will write all the values and I will take the graph and I will show you how to do the plottings for 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Now I have done 4.5, so 5, 5.5, 6, 6.5, 7, 7.5, 8, 8.5, 9, 9.5. So I will write the measured pH value here. So this is 1.98, 2.29, 2.38. Could you see the pH value is gradually increases? You could not see enormous difference. So it is increasing only gradually. And then 2.87, 3.12, 3.42, 3.72, and 11.30, 11.44, 11.54. Now you see here, from here it is increases gradually. So it is increases gradually. From, you see, 8 to 8.5, so it increases, jumping the value from 3 to 11.30. It indicates that, so here only you have the end point. So you do not know whether it comes on 8 or it comes on 8.5. So once you plot the graph only, you will come to know whether it is 8 or 8.5. So I have written up to 20. I will write the remaining values also. Where it is stop, 9.5, and this is 11.59, 11.6, 64, 11.67, 11.72, 11.76, 11.80, 11.84, 11.90, 11.94, 11.99 and 12. So I told you already the pH will be approximately from 1 and approximately to 12. Now after completing all the values from the pH meter, so you have to tablet it. So once you tablet it, what you have to do? So you have to find out delta pH. So what is delta pH? So you know already what is delta pH. So delta pH is equal to pH2 minus pH1. What is pH1? What is pH2? Now for 0, it is nothing. So you put dash. This is pH2 minus pH1. You will plot only here. Clear? And pH3 minus pH2, you will write here. pH4 minus pH2, you will write here. The first 0 value will be nothing. So you can directly put a dash. So I will write all the values. So this value, so you can tablet it also. So 0.02. 0.01, 0.0. Don't think that it will increase or decrease. It will come randomly. It may not increase or it may not decrease. It will come randomly. But here you have to see the trend. It has to increase gradually. At some point of time, it may be 8, it may be 9, or it may be 10, 11, 12. Don't fix the value. So you will see the gradual change. Where you are getting the gradual change, there you will have the end point. So now I have tabulated all the values. Calculated all delta pH. Then what is delta V? So delta V is nothing but as usual V2 minus V1. So here nothing will come. So what you have to do? V2 minus V1. V2 minus V1. But we are adding, we are taking the pH value after each 0.5 ml addition. So your delta V will be a constant value. So what is that value? So you will have only 0.5. Because we are taking all the pH value only after 0.5 addition, so all will be 0.5. So uniformly you write 0.5 for delta V. So once we calculate this one, this, and what is the next step? Delta pH by delta V. So this value we have to divide by 0.5 and you have to write the value. So then we have completed the entire tabular column. So once we completed the entire tabular column, so what we have to do? We have to do the plotting. Now I'll write this value also. By using calculator also you can calculate. So we will be providing the observation. So what you have to do? Take the graph sheet. Like this, okay. So you have to take in the graph sheet, in the x-axis volume of sodium hydroxide. So in the y-axis you will take delta pH by delta V. So now what is the volume we have added? So 0 to 15. So you can go up to 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, up to 15 ml. And how to fix the y-axis scale means, so you see the delta pH by delta V value. You see what is the highest point. If it is 7, you can go by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. If it is greater than 15 or 10, and you can 4. So depending upon the highest value of delta pH by delta V, based on that only you will fix the scale. Now you plot everything in the x-axis, the volume of sodium hydroxide. In the y-axis, you will take delta pH by delta V value. Then you plot all the points. The graph will be like this. I will do it here. Now you will take what you will take. So you will take volume of sodium hydroxide in ml in the x-axis. So this side delta pH by delta V in the y-axis. So now this is my x and this is my y. So now you take 0 to 15. So depending upon the highest value, in our case here, what is my highest value? 15.16. Either I can go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 or I can go 1, 2, 2, 4, 6, 8, 9, 10, like this. So again I am taking, so 1, 2, 15. So you plot all the points. How you will get? So the plottings will come like this. Now here you will get. So now where I am getting the end point here? So I am getting the end point only 8.5. Now this is 8.5 means only here I will get a highest point like this. The other points may fall like this. So what you have to do? These points join smoothly by hand. So from here to here you take the scale and join and bring it down and mark the point like this. Clear? Now, so this is the point you should bring it down. by using the scale and put a dotted line. So how much I am getting? So I am getting 8.5 ml. Now this is the end point of this titration. So 8.5 ml is the amount of sodium hydroxide required for calculate the H plus ion concentration present in the solution. So this is the graph. After tabulating all the values, after completing the calculations, so you should take the x-axis. In the x-axis, you have to take volume of sodium hydroxide. So in the y-axis, you should take delta pH by delta V. Both are there in the tabular column. So what you have to take? 0, 1, 2, 3, up to 15, because we have done only 15 ml. And here, depending upon the pH value, if it is crossing, exceeding 20, you go the scale 2, 4, 6, 8, 9, 10, etc. Or if it is not exceeding 15, what you will do? You go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, like this, etc. And you will plot all the points. So as I told you already, so you will plot like this, okay? Only one point will be the maximum. Sometimes due to some error, you may get 2 to 3 points, but you should see only the highest point which is crossing over the other. In my case, I am getting only the highest point, only at 8.5. This I conclude for my titration, 8.5 ml is the end point. So where you will get these lines, you should draw smoothly by hand, and these two by scale, and make it up. So it will like a comb shape. See, now we have calculated the end point from the graph. I have shown you already. So what is the end point? 8.5 ml. So I have mentioned here. I have shown the graph also for a model graph. So what you have to write? So this value corresponds to sodium hydroxide. So what you will do? Now you have to do the calculation. So volume of sodium hydroxide. How much? This is 8.5 ml. I have obtained only from the graph. Then normality of sodium hydroxide N1, it was given in the amol itself. This is a standard sodium hydroxide we are preparing, so we will know the strength. So how much? This is 0.01 N. So next one, volume of HCl solution. So how much we prepared out in the beaker? 20 ml. So you should write 20 ml. So what is our aim? We need to calculate the strength. Strength is nothing but normality. So normality of HCl N2 is equal to how much? Simple volumetric calculation. So what you will do? V1 N1 is equal to V2 N2, where N2 is equal to V1 N1 divided by V2. How much? 8.5 into 0.5 divided by 20. V1 N1 divided by V2. So I have substituted all the values. The value is 0.0525 N. So now this is the strength of HCl present in the given solution. Then you have to write the result. The strength of given HCl solution is found to be 0.0425 N. So that's all about this pH titration. I think I have explained you clearly. So like this, in future with some more experiments or theoretical concepts, I will meet you again. Thank you all.